Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another episode of the Good Old Fashioned Philly Wrestling Podcast.
Back on the road, because I'm on the road right now.
So we are back on the motherfucking road once again.
Yep.
Here I am on the road again.
Yep, I'm on the road.
So Alan, you gotta tell me where you're at, man. Where you at?
I'm driving on good old 76, the good old Schuylkill Expressway.
Oh man, he's doing it. He's doing it.
Yep.
I'm sitting on my ass at my house, but I'll tell you what, man. I wanted to talk a little bit about pro wrestling because we had some shit going on this week, man. First off, I gotta just start it with this, all right? I could not watch Monday Night Raw. Monday Night, no diss to WWE, but it's just I don't get what they're trying to do. I then moved over to AEW on Wednesday night, and I saw one of the best hardcore matches I've ever seen in a women's division with Thunder Rosa versus Britt Baker. What did you think about that match, Alan? I'll tell you what I think.
I thought that match was freaking awesome. I know, like, you don't see that. WWE has gotten so soft since back when I first started watching it and all, or back in the Attitude Era, because, like, in WWE, you never see anyone pull out thumbtacks in a match. Like, and I know anytime I see a bag of thumbtacks come out, I know something special is going to happen. And when Britt Baker pulled out those thumbtacks, all of a sudden, like, that kid inside of me started lighting up and popping on the inside. I was like, that's something you never see in WWE anymore. And, like, it
that's
happened
awesome.
In AEW.
That's awesome, man. I was watching the show, and when it started to happen, it gained my interest because I remember when we saw Thunder Rosa at the ECW arena.
Yeah, I remember.
She was signing autographs, and I saw how humble she was. It blew my mind then, and then when I saw this match, it was blowing my mind because I was like, this woman is making this match go over so well, and if you even watch all the stuff they did, she pulled it off so perfect with all the hardcore moves and shit.
Yeah.
And Britt Baker was a good sport and went Mick Foley with it or whatever in her own way. But Thunder Rosa is the person to watch in all of this AEW stuff. I mean, she is phenomenal.
Yeah, she is. And like, dude, they just took the women's division to a whole new level, because like I'd never seen a women's hardcore match like that. And honestly, like brought me back to like the old how I used to feel like whenever I used to watch like Mick Foley in the Hell in a Cell match, the King of the Death match with Terry Funk.
Yeah, the Japanese stuff. Yeah.
Yeah.
So with that being said, I'm predicting that Thunder Rosa is going to be the breakout star in AEW. That's my new prediction. And then also like, you know, there's a lot going on in the podcast world. We got Big Jim Cornette out there doing his thing, basically dominating the wrestling world at this time, at this moment in time. Is he not?
Yeah, he is. Like Jim Cornette.
In his own way, he's dominating what's going on. Like he's a one-man show, or he's got Brian Lashley, but they're a two-man show that's going head-to-head with, like, you know, billion-dollar companies.
Dude, he's on fire, dude.
And then I like some of the other podcasts and stuff, too, because we saw some of these guys on AEW a couple weeks ago. We saw Bischoff. I forget who else was there, Wade Keller or Bill After. I don't know. One of them guys were there, man. But Hannibal, too. I know that you're friends with Hannibal, so I don't know. Any Hannibal stories?
All I know is, like, the one time I did do an interview with Hannibal, like, about the ghost hunting. Because I remember, like, the one year on Halloween, like, Hannibal was, like, looking for someone that has experience in the paranormal investigating, and I was telling him about some of the investigations I've done, and he actually did the interview with me over Skype, and, where he was asking me about some paranormal investigations I've done and stuff, so it was kind of actually pretty cool being interviewed by Hannibal. But not in the wrestling realm, but in the paranormal realm.
That's cool, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, he's got some good guests on his show. Like, every now and then I'll go over to Hannibal's page, and I'll just be like, wow, he's got some really good guests on here.
Yeah.
And with Bischoff shit, I just like hearing all the behind-the-scenes stuff with WCW, and that reminds me, because with AEW now, I'm starting to actually feel like AEW is better than WWE at this moment. I know that's crazy to say that as far as the numbers go and the money game goes, but as far as the product, I'm willing to watch AEW on Wednesday nights. I can't watch Monday Night Raw anymore. So I'm looking at AEW as it's filling a void where WCW used to be. And I'm really surprised with how much I'm liking it because, you know, I always liked WCW. Of course, I was a WCW guy at the height of the NWO stuff. But at the same time, I've always been a Northeast wrestling guy, you know, being out of Philly. Yeah. I mean, so, you know, with WCW, I know that's a whole other culture and a down south thing. And, you know, over the years, I've been, like, kind of, like, checking out, like, you know, for example, like, Master P did shit with WCW. And I was surprised when I went back and looked at that. I was like, why did he do this? And I'm like, well, this is, like, a down south thing.
Yeah, and I did
up here in the Northeast, we don't always understand how all that works down there.
Yeah, and I did see recently, too, like, Tully Blanchard actually stepped back in the ring again in AEW.
Yeah, so he was teamed up with FTR. I saw that match. And now they're rolling with, what's his name now?
I forget.
They're rolling with Jericho, right?
Yeah.
So Jericho's with FTR and Tully now. I haven't really seen it. Because I just checked in at the very end to see that last match. I saw maybe two other matches on the card. But overall, AEW, like, is dead. See, okay, here's the other thing. Kenny Omega and Don Callis, all right? These motherfuckers really make you hate them. And I'm saying that as in, like, I'm not putting them over in that sense because I'm almost a little disappointed with how it's going down, but they make you legitimately not like them.
Yeah.
So they're doing something right as heels, but it's, you know, I don't know, man. I mean, I'd like to see Cornette and Kenny Omega go at it because I know Cornette's so good at cutting some of these guys down that it becomes almost like he becomes like almost their best critic.
Yeah.
And then they up the game because of shit that he said. I've seen that happen a couple different times already. And, you know, it's almost like Cornette is just bullying these guys. But at the same time, it's what needs to happen because if these guys just go out and do what they're going to do, it's not going to make sense.
Yeah, like, I actually saw, like, something that Cornette posted up a podcast where, like, he was talking about The Miz and MJF. And honestly, though, like, that's one thing that kind of sucked in the last couple of weeks when The Miz beat Drew McIntyre for the title after, like, cashing in. It was a cheap victory, too, because he had Bobby Lashley came out and beat down Drew McIntyre so that The Miz just came out and picked up the pieces and got a cheap victory. That, in my opinion, like, yeah, The Miz, dude, I was like, dude. He sucks.
Yeah, he makes you want to turn off the TV, right?
But the thing is, too, like, I know, like, MJF, in my opinion, is way better than Miz.
I agree.
Yeah.
I agree. And this is where it starts to get interesting because, like, we're seeing the tides shift here with AEW. It's also, like, if you look at the roster, I mean, Bobby Lashley, to me, is one of the guys that stands out in WWE right now. I love Bobby Lashley, okay? But then you got guys like MJF, and you got fucking people coming up down in AEW. I mean, the roster's starting to grow. You got fucking Shaquille O'Neal over there. You know what I mean?
And actually, too, like, in the indies, too, like, when it comes to MJF, like, one person I think that kind of, like, gives off that MJF vibe is, this dude in SWF, Jimmy Controversy. Like, this guy, like, he's going places. Like, I could actually see later down, at some point down the line, Jimmy Controversy versus MJF.
Yeah, that'll be an epic battle of generations right there. Because, you know, MJF definitely by far the best wrestler to come out of this smartphone era of pro wrestling, and we can go beyond that for MJF because MJF will transcend that in his career. But then at the same time, you got these guys like Jimmy Controversy coming up from Generation Z, who, you know, this dude's one of the best heels I've ever seen. Like, this is how I feel about Jimmy Controversy. It's the same shit with what Bill Watts said about Cornette. I'm mesmerized by Jimmy Controversy.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know why. I don't know what it is, but Jimmy Controversy is that guy that leaves an impression on you.
Yeah, and then Jimmy Controversy at the last SWF show that we did, too, like, he went up against New Jack.
Yeah.
And I still remember, like, that thing, what was that happening, like, Doink the Clown, like, pie, hit someone with a pie face.
Doink the Clown pied somebody, and then New Jack hugged him, and they all just laughed about it. It was so funny.
Yeah,
it was. One of the best things I saw, though, that whole day was not during the show. It was what New Jack was saying to Jimmy Controversy when we were all just kind of getting together or whatever. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, New Jack was talking shit like, Jimmy, I'm coming for you. You know, you're going to run like a bitch. Jimmy, I'm going to beat you down. He was saying like this crazy shit. And man, it was one of those moments, man, where I just knew that these fucking guys, you know, had their shit together on this angle, man.
Yeah.
And you know, I gotta say this too. Like, you know, I followed New Jack's pretty much whole career. I saw all the ECW stuff. I was there. You know, New Jack seems to be on his game right now.
Yeah.
Like, you know, you hear all these stories about the dude. Like, but like when we saw him, man, he was nothing but professional, and he was nothing but in good spirits, which made everybody else in the whole place have a better time.
Yeah, and didn't you give New Jack one of your CDs, too?
So I gave New Jack an old-school hip-hop DJ mix that I made, which was some shit. I gathered a bunch of cool shit, and the Matula Shakur song was on there, and the Outlaws, and I think Cole 187 of them. So I hope New Jack received that, because, you know, that's some good shit right there. You know what I mean? I like to be able to vibe out on some Generation X and before hip-hop.
Yeah.
With New Jack.
Yeah.
So, yeah. But, yeah, so good old-fashioned Philly Wrestling Podcast. I mean, if there's anything else I want to say, it is about SWF, man. SWF's got really good crew that they're doing their thing with right now, and it would be really cool to see what could happen with some SWF-CCW matches, man. Alan, if you want to do any dream booking or anything like that, man, then now might be the time, man.
Yeah, because actually at the next show we got coming up on March 27th, which you guys could all watch on viewstub.com. If you can't make it out, we will be live streaming it. It's SWF Get in the Ring on viewstub.com. And in the description below, I'll even put a link so you can order it for like $15 to watch it anywhere around the world. But Gangrel from WWE, he's gonna be there.
Oh man, the Vampire Warrior, man.
Yeah, he'll be taking on
Gangrel.
He'll be taking on Rhett Titus.
Yeah, I gotta say, man, Gangrel's one of my favorites, and I would love to be able to sit down and talk with that man.
Yeah, and also too, like, in the last week, Molly Holly, she was inducted into the 2021 WWE Hall of Fame.
How about that, man?
Yeah, that was pretty dope. I remember, like, me and you, Rick, we went up to New York for her seminar, and I had to...
Yeah, Staten Island, man. Congratulations to Molly Holly on her WWE Hall of Fame inductee.
Yep.
Induction. Congratulations, Molly, if you're out there listening.
Yeah, congratulations, Molly.
And, yeah, man, so we're just trying to hold it down here for Philly Pro Wrestling, man. And then you also see, you know, you see Pillman Jr. in AEW, and, you know, he's starting to get some shine up there, man. So what I'm saying is you're seeing it here at the Pro Wrestling Archives. This is the good old-fashioned Philly Wrestling Podcast. My name is Rick Reinhardt. This is Alan Fenstermaker saying good night.
Good night.